Absolutely wunderbar.
Noch keine Frage bitte. In Englisch bitte, ja.
How did you get stuck doing this?
How did you like the Dawn of the Dead remake?
The Dawn of the Dead remake. It was better than I thought it was. Better than I expected it was going to be. I thought the first 10 or 15 minutes were pretty good. And after that, it just sort of became an action flick or something. I don't like the idea of zombies running. I think their ankles would snap. Some serious talk about a sequel to Land. And I don't know if it's going to happen yet. There's no contract yet. But the DVD sales continue to be successful. I think they may want to do one quickly. I'd almost rather wait for a while and see if there's some sort of a change, a political change, or a change in the climate. But if they decide to do it, we'll do it. We'll basically have to do it, or else I'll have to give up the franchise. They can't do it without me, but if I say no, they can do it on their own. So the cool thing is that I might be able to get to work with these guys again, I think if I had to do one quickly, I would just continue the story. So, there's no change in the world. I just do part two, literally part two, after a brief intermission.
Mr. Romero, I have a question. What did you enjoy? The early movies with low budget, under pressure and strain? Or did you like the latter, Land of the Dead, where you had big budget thrown in the movie? Or larger budget, I should say.
Yeah, but we were still under budget, and there was still a lot of strains. I mean, man, this film was not... Everyone says, boy, you got to work with a big budget now. Forget about it. The remake of Dawn had about 12 million more than we had. And we were... Everybody had to... have to put in 120% to make this movie happen.
Christian. Hello.
When I first saw the film Land of the Dead, I was...
I'm sorry, man. It's really hard to hear you guys.
Okay.
You have a little more of a... A little more...
Okay, I try. My question is, why is Land of the Dead only about 90 minutes? I mean, Dawn of the Dead was very nice because it durates a long time, and so you have time to develop the characters, maybe. Why was this one so short?
Well, I mean, we didn't set out to make it short. it was the, that was the story. We shot the script, basically. It was very little that we didn't get. And we were able to actually go back. We went back for 3 days and picked up a couple of things. We cut out the scene of this scene with Leguizamo in the other apartment, the other penthouse apartment, from the theatrical release. It didn't seem to work as well as it might have. But we didn't. There was nothing, that we cut or anything like that. It was just that's how long it took to tell the story.
Christian, please.
Do you judge the development of special editions? Do you think it's good that the studios force such a strong re-release policy? I mean, is it possible to say you made Dawn of the Dead or you made one film? Because after a couple of years, you have 3 or 4 different editions of the film, each 2 minutes longer. Is it still a single artistic expression of yours, or is it just watering down because of the re-release policy and adding 5 minutes each time?
Well, they can't add anything that I shot, because I only shot so much. I mean, there were basically 3 versions of Dawn of the Dead. It was my first cut, and then when we made the deal to make the film, Dario Argento came in with half the money guy in the group who came in with that money. And part of the deal was that he had the right. He didn't think that, he thought that he would be more in touch with European audiences than I would. So he reserved the right to cut the film for European audiences. Basically, he cut out a lot of the humor, a lot of the American sort of, you know, references to the mall, and that was his version of the film. So that's two. Then when we got U.S. distribution, they asked me to cut it down, not for violence, but for purely for running time. So I cut, I don't remember how many minutes out of it. Those are the only three versions that we actually made. People that were involved with the film actually only did those three versions. Now here there's a Japanese version where they're in space and they're on a rocket ship and the satellite blows up and all this stuff. So none of us had anything to do with that. Rip. Peter shoots himself and then she kills herself in the helicopter.
But it was never shot.
It was shot. I didn't remember this, so I got in an argument for it because Savini said, oh yeah, we shot that. And I didn't remember because we never did the effects. All we did was we shot Fran standing on it. That's all we shot. We never did the effects. I had this idea that I didn't want to restore order. And it occurred to me somewhere in the middle of that film that you can leave the world in chaos and you can still save a couple of people in life. So I decided from that point on I didn't have to kill everything.
Currently working on being in Germany. I just finished working on a movie called, a cable feature called Knights of the South Bronx, and then a movie of the week called Doomstown. And that was my last recording. So right now I'm just waiting for the next one. You got a camera there. What you doing with that camera? Is that professional? You gonna sell this or something? I want my piece of the pie, baby.
I got a couple TV shows that I've
done. He's currently working on this guy's film.
Because if that guy's film right there is our next project.
What's his dots? What's happening?
Sorry, the next thing that we got out is right here will be Get Rich Without Trying, 50 Cent's film. Working on a couple of other things that I'm trying to put together myself. It might be a while till you see it, but started working on it.
Oh yeah, I'm working on it. I'm working on
it. Nice then. Let's photo shoot you. Shannon and Clayton begin in 40 minutes.
Yes, in 40 minutes. That's a good thing, yeah. I'm working on some music. Some love music. Yeah, some very white music. Like, hey, what's that? How you doing? Fuck you, Doc.
I'm working. I've got two Stephen King projects. I don't know which one is going to go. One is, they're both novels. One is The Girl Who Loved Tom Gordon, and the other one is called From a Viewing Egg. I don't know, you know, it depends on who writes the first check. And there's suddenly some, a lot of talk about a sequel to Land of the Dead, but I don't know if it's really going to happen or not. Depends on the CDs.
So keep buying the DVDs.
Hi, this is for Eugene and Pedro. You very good in looking in the same scene in Land of the Dead, but did you hang out on the set? Or is the most time you spent here at the convention?
We did not meet on set. He had days off when I was working. I had days off was when he was working. So, but we hung out. Actually, become pretty good friends since then. Since I would say the screenings, right? Probably like the LA premiere and then
the LA premiere.
And then we've been friends since then.
He answered it.
Sometimes he doesn't like me so much, but.
Noch keine Frage für George oder?
Okay. Anyone? No?
That's it.
Don't be shy. I know you have questions.
what is the next movie?
What, for me?
I don't know the title. There was a movie that made, and I think it's mentioned on the DVD of Night of the Living Dead, but I forgot the title. There's Sheila.
That's finally being released on DVD, I think. I think it's called The Affair. They keep changing the titles. But I think it's finally going to be released on DVD. It's the only one that hasn't. Right after, the second film that I made, right after the book. Yeah, but we used to do theater commercials and industrial films, and that's how we got the equipment for lights and the news for the news. But, you know, in those days, man, I mean, the news was on film, there was no video. So, cities the size of Pittsburgh had film libraries, and that's how we were able to sort of get started.
I'm kind of father. Okay, I have one. Oh.
Here he is. What's the name of your movie?
Dead Eyes Open.
That's right, I remember that.
Reaction letter said, and I mean, they gave George and the movie so much love. If they could capture that and just make that an addition to the DVD, it was awesome. That was the highlight. It was awesome. I mean, in the process of doing the movie, it was so much work that there was no time to think about highlight. I mean,
the high point every day was just getting back to the hotel.
Just getting it done. Exactly. Not freezing your feet off. Not freezing in the water. Not having your eyes get infected from contacts that you forgot to wash your hands and figure them out, you know. But the high point was actually being in Philadelphia. If you could have all been there, it was absolutely amazing. Directors came from all over the place. Jim George, it was awesome. But it was good.
I was going to say that was the high point for me too, was that the Pittsburgh screening. I mean, it was just a blowout. I mean, it was a packed house all the way, big old theater with a balcony and just a packed house. And people came, the guys from Shaun of the Dead came, and Tarantino and Rodriguez, see the film. And the film plays better than I think any film has ever played.
I mean, we just all sat there and
loved it. I mean, you know, that was completely happening.
Recognition is so important, and you've got it.
It's not even the recognition. It's like, you know, you do this work, and it's quite hard.
So much love in that room that day. You could feel the energy. People walked out of there weeping, and it was just wow. That definitely goes to one of my favorite days.
It's also an affirmation when anyone works, spends hours and blood, sweat, and tears to get something completed, and then to have an appreciative audience. And when they get it, because there are many places where they got it. So when they laugh in the right places, it's the right places. You know, I'm sure for George that day, it was just, they got it. And it's an affirmation, you know, wow. That was the first time I would love to do another big movie, because if it's like this, and a lot of times it's not always like that. You'll go to a screen, and they're like, what is he trying to do?
And Father?
Yeah. So Mr. Romero, you mentioned in your answer Quentin Tarantino. How was his reaction on the movie? And would you like to think if Tarantino reminiscent in his movie one of your work?
Oh, I don't know. dinner or anything like that. He does something quite different than his stuff is quite different. Maybe he does come from what's closer to the stuff that I do than a lot of his other people. His reaction, I don't know, I mean, Quinn reacts the same way to everything. Very excitedly.
Come on, I'll tell you quite quick. It was awesome. Anytime he calls me when I'm available, I'm there. Anytime he calls me and if I can get out of something, I'm there. It's awesome working with him. I didn't know that George was as big as he is in the mind of Jordan, okay? So once I found out later, once I saw all the homage that's been paid him in Philadelphia, and other places, I thought, I have a friend named Bobby, who's a great jazz musician. And jazz, and Bobby said that, he goes, Mom, he goes, it's heavy, you know. It's real heavy, deep. He said, but it's good people, real people, you know. He's a cool cat. And you don't get all that, I mean, he doesn't, I'm sure he's pleased with the adulation, but after all, he goes, yo, chill. You know? So he's a great guy. Great director to work for, and I work for
him. Me too, I work, no matter what it is, he calls up. He's a great director and even better person, so. And all it takes is just a few minutes around him and you can see it. Thank you guys.
Better than I expected it was gonna be. I mean, I thought that Jack did a pretty good job at making an action film, but I thought really that's all it was an action film. It was more like a video game. I thought the first 10 or 15 minutes were really terrific. I felt that sort of lost its reason for being contained in this film. And I don't think zombies should run.
Instead, they were all messed up.
Okay.
Mr. Romero, would you agree that when you're forced to work on a film with an insufficient budget, that it can be helpful to improvise? Or would you rather say, give me a couple of million dollars and I can do a better job?
You know, that's a really tough question. I mean, it would take a half an hour to really answer all, you know, with all the possibilities. That, you know, that question opens up a million possibilities. Improvisation, first of all, I'm always open to it. I never feel that the script is carved in stone in any way. I mean, you write a script and all of a sudden, finally, you see the set, changes your attitude a little bit, you meet the actors which completely influence your thinking about the way to play certain things and improvisation, I love. It's difficult to do because all the department heads, you know, you want to say, wait a minute, I want a knife instead of a gun, you know, and then the prop guy's going nuts on it. So you have to know, you have to do things within reasonable limits. But I'm always open to suggestions. I mean, there are things in this film that these guys did that, you know, that were just creative and came out of the moment, as long as it fit the overall concept, man. I mean, I just let it in all the time. Dennis's line when he says zombies, man, they freak me out. That was his line. It was his invention. And then he comes over and says, you know what? Is it okay if I pick my nose while I'm doing it? But I said, yeah!
Haben wir noch keine? On behalf of everyone, I'd like to say thank you for coming to Germany. This has been awesome here with everyone. So good.